my DIY experience, I chose to visit a beekeeper named Erta Schadel, who keeps a hive at the Volkler Orth Museum in Flushing, New York. The Volkler Orth Museum is a Victorian house that was previously owned by the Orth family and now serves as a community museum with an English-style garden and bird sanctuary. Mrs. Schadel has been keeping bees for the majority of her life. Originally from Germany, she learned how to keep bees when she was very little from her father, who was a master beekeeper. As a child, Mrs. Schadel desperately wanted to help her father with the hives. Since she was too small to fit in a beekeeping suit, she would venture outside without any protection and learned how to keep bees with her bare hands. Trying to convince her father that she could help him, she never showed pain if she would get stung, so that he would let her continue to learn. Oh, and the pot is hot. Honey in the honey pot. Oh, and the pot. Today, Mrs. Schadel only wears a beekeeping suit to show visitors. She's more comfortable working without one, and says that her body has worked up resistance to bee stings. Mrs. Schadel showed me the process of how she takes care of her beehives. When she has guests, she uses a smoker to make sure that the bees are calmer and to have them retreat into the hives. She then proceeds to take apart the different sections of the hive and checks each frame to make sure the honey production is going smoothly and to check and see if there are any larvae. When I asked Mrs. Schadel if there was any part of beekeeping that she got frustrated with, she quickly replied nothing because she loves it so much. However, she did bring up the fact that it's become increasingly hard to keep the bees alive during the winter, something that she previously never had to worry about. With the bee population decreasing each year, she feels a kind of obligation to keep the practice and the bees alive, and therefore does her best to teach and mentor others on their journey to becoming beekeepers. After around 40 years of practice, Mrs. Schadel says that teaching how to keep bees has become her profession and her passion. From her extensive experience with bees, she says that she's learned a lot from working with them. She admires their discipline, their hard work, their organization, and their contribution to preserving the beauty of nature through the process of pollination. They have given her a great deal of patience. If we are questioning whether or not beekeeping leads to a more fulfilled life, it's clear that for Mrs. Schadel, that answer is yes. I think it's safe to say that without beekeeping, Mrs. Schadel's life wouldn't be the same. From her relationship with her father to the relationship she's built through sharing her love for bees, Mrs. Schadel is passing down the art of bees from generation to generation. From my perspective, this experience has inspired me to learn more about beekeeping. Maybe in the future I'll have a hive of my own where I can pass down the stories of Mrs. Schadel and any others that I will meet in the community of beekeepers. Cheers to the honeybees.